Hi guys, my name is Erica and I'm going to be showing you how to make the unicorn inspired Converse shoes. So I will start with this one. I don't know if I showed you prior to that, but I use the Swarovski crystals and I use them in size SS16. It's listed here. I like to use this pencil. It pretty much picks up the rhinestone. It does leave some type of residue on it, but then once the shoe's dry, you can pretty much just clean it off or wipe it off, whatever. And E6000. So what I usually like to do is just put a little dot there. And I like to use a toothpick. But I don't have one, so I'm going to be using this little thing here. So what I do is I get some of the glue, and I start by sections, because this stuff glues on pretty good, actually, pretty fast. I try not to just put it along the side, not really on the black line here. Because I won't be gluing any rhinestones there. So just try to work clean and fast. This can take a while, so you're gonna have to have a lot of patience. So this is what the front of the shoe will look like, and this is what the back will look like. So moving along, on this section, since it's fabric, I just kind of put the glue like that, and then I kind of just blend it in. That makes sense. Ribbon or gold foil things in there. When you're gonna cut it, just kind of leave a bigger section because you don't know how much you're gonna need to roll around. So we do the same thing for this one. You fold it there, put some glue here. Put there. Whenever you have hot glue, you can always use your scissors. It'll kind of cool it faster, and you'll just be able to take it right off. So then, again, you bring this section forward. You're going to put that through the middle there, and then you're going to fold this again. And that should be like that, and then hopefully this is making sense. Then you put the glue along this edge. So you should end up with something that looks like this. See? So here I have some cotton balls. And I'm gonna kind of just fray one. Reason for it is because you want less cotton at the tip here. That there. They should be about the same length. Except this one. See how I think I pulled it out too hard? So I'm gonna just put a little bit of glue there and fold it down. Well, you need to be careful when you're pulling the this portion up. Match the other one. Hopefully you look about the same. Somewhat the same. So next what I'm going to do, the horn about there. So make it the sure it's in the center. Yeah, it's about centered. And you can kind of flatten it out once it's on the section you want it. So it should look something like that. Just with that. I think it's purple. Maybe the other two will give it a pop of color on the sides. So I have ironed on the eyelashes. Okay, so I've already made one. I'm not sure if I'm gonna leave it like this. I'm not sure if I like the ears or the bow. So, because it's kind of hiding away from the eyes. Material, it's like leathery. You can find this at Hobby Lobby. Each sheet is about $1.67. So anyways, I just pretty much like trace it and then cut. I put a little bit of glue here and then just add them to there, to the back of the shoe. There. Fold it. That way you can insert it there. So you form a little shoelace type deal there. And we do the same for this side. you will tie this in here. Once you put it on the toddler, you can, or the kid's foot, you can see how much ribbon you're going to be using, and you can cut any of the excess. So this will be hidden for the moment in there, in the shoe. And this, we're going to make a pretty, not too tight, bow in the front, since the second one is going to be out instead of in. This will be seen through the outside. And just kind of fix the bow how you want it. Once it's on the shoe, you can kind of poof it up and just do whatever you like. So there goes that. Once we have that, I get these little clips from Walmart. They're kind of flat on one side, and then they have like a little clip thing on the back. So I just put a little dab of glue there. The flat back on there. You can cut any excess thread you have there. I used to have some little unicorns, some felt unicorns, and I was thinking about adding those in the center, but I can't find them for some reason. I don't know where they're at. So I'm just going to be using these flat back buttons. I'm not quite sure if I'm going to leave these bows on, but for the moment, I'm just going to leave them on. Unless I find something else cuter that I have somewhere in here in this room. So there's your bow. And then you pretty much just insert it wherever you want. I'm going to insert it inside the bow here. Once it's on the shoe, just give it a little puff. Fix it, of course, because it's a little sad. So here we have it.